White ware you're talking about?
Yes.
Oh.
So these are the white wares from the northern kilns in China, most probably from the Xing kilns or the Xing kilns. That was again the best known of all the kilns that was making white wares. And perhaps, oh well, in the next case we can see other objects. What is amazing is that why Chinese ceramics or white wares from China were so prized is because if you look at it, it has a very clean, a very pure quality. And then the glaze, of course, because these are objects again that have been under the sea for more than 1,000 years, often the glaze has been rather worn off, like we can see on the big jar. But yet you notice how white actually the ceramic body was. And then this is, and I mean, part of the success of Chinese white ware was because of the ingredients, the purity of the ingredients, as well as the kiln technology that allowed only very sturdy objects to be fired at higher temperatures. That, you know, at that point in time, other people around the world very much desired but couldn't replicate to the same extent as what the Chinese potters were producing. You notice that they are very thinly potted as well, for example, like these saucers or stands for the cups. And from these two cups that we can see, you notice that cross influences between different media, so between ceramics and metalware, there was often a lot of the interactions or exchanges, and then these are represented in the objects that were made, because these ring handles is more likely to have been inspired by a metal prototype than something that a Chinese potter would have done.
Is this still practiced today in China?
As in
The white ceramics, are they still being made today?
Yeah, I mean, there are people still making white wares or monochromes, as we call it, the plainer objects. But of course, people, I would say, because there are so many production centers actually in China, so there are, I mean, all sorts of ceramics.